So excited to bring it to the stage. Ladies and gentlemen, Rob Hayes.
I'm tired of defending my decision to move to LA. I'm originally from Atlanta, Georgia. My friends back home, they pay the same amount I do a month, but they got a front yard. They got a backyard. They got an upstairs. They got a downstairs. I just got a room in a room. That's it. One of those rooms is so many rooms at the same time. It's a kitchen. It's an office. It's a gym. It's a hallway. It's a foyer. My friends, they got the room nobody goes in. You ever go over to somebody's house and be like, yeah, nobody goes in that room. They got that room. My friends, they got rules. You ever go over to somebody's house and be like, everybody takes their shoes off when they come over. Somebody ever ask you to take your shoes off, it's not a good sock day? You got holes in your socks? You got to move those holes to the bottom? Hold on to them with your toes like this? I'm like, what's wrong with your foot? Don't worry about my foot. I stepped on something earlier. This is nice. This is a nice place. They got new furniture. You ever sit on a couch so new, you like, if I pass gas, it's gonna bounce right off. It's definitely gonna make a noise if I do it. This couch don't have any seepage. I gotta waste my, do you have a bathroom on gas? I be so jealous when I go in the bathroom, I be like, man, they made it. They got the little troll hair on the toilet, they on another level. Go back to my bathroom and be so plain. I mean, my friends are always like, how do you live in LA? It's so expensive. I'm like, it's easy. I moved there from New York. At least I have space. When I lived in New York, I shared a basement with another comedian. Two grown men separated by a curtain. You know what everything sounds like when you're separated by a curtain? That's what I thought I had to do to get on. Other comedians had doors in our apartment. I had roommates upstairs. They'd be like, I'm going to my room. I'd be like, I'm going to my area. One of them had a dog. The dog would always be in my area. One time I left and came back, the dog was in my bed. I was like, who tucked you in? How'd that even happen? I'm scared of dogs. Like, it was torture for me. I can never get the first pet. Normal people, they pet a dog, it's fine. Whenever I try to pet a dog, I put my hand out, the dog can smell the fear. Then it does one of these. Then I move my hand back like this, and then the dog's like, oh, we playing bite the finger? I love bite the finger. I can't wait to play bite the finger. I hate bite the finger. I've gotten better though. Like, I'll watch a dog on TV. Like, I'll watch a dog on television. I'm not that scared. Like, I watch the Westminster Dog Show. They have so many different types of dogs. They kept introducing dogs. I fell asleep, woke up, they were still introducing dogs. They got dogs with waves on their tails and on their ears. I'm like, who's brushing these ears down until they get waves? What's that dog bed made out of? Durag? The Westminster Dog Show has not missed a year since its inception. Since 1877, they have not missed a year. Not to COVID, not to world wars, not to the Great Depression. That means somebody in the 1930s was like, hey, it's rough out here. People having trouble eating. Maybe we shouldn't have the dog show. And somebody else was like, these dogs are broke too. Let's see who has the best broke dog. They got so many. many different types of dogs. Did y'all know there are other retrievers other than golden retrievers? That's the problem. Hollywood's not casting these brown and black retrievers. They watching TV like, I could catch a touchdown pass. I could pretend to have a family. Y'all ever notice Air Bud never happens around black people? It's always an all-white neighborhood where there's like, ain't no rule that says a dog can't play basketball. Like, that's a movie I want to make. I want to make Air Bud AAU Tournament. Just a bunch of little black kids crossing the mess out of Air Bud, just woo-hoo! Woo-hoo-hoo! Woo! Blocking Air Bud's shot out of its mouth like, woo! You too little. You can't see me. Air Bud come back home looking all sad, like, I don't think I'm gonna get a scholarship. This basketball thing is too hard. My friends back home, they say stuff to me all the time that I can't relate to. I see their posts, they be like, oh yeah, we had to buy a new house. #adulting. You don't have to buy a house to be an adult. You just got to get older. They always taking pictures with that big key. I be so jealous of that big key. When you get an apartment, nobody takes a picture with you. You fill out that paperwork, then you got to leave. I want that big key. I got nowhere to put it. If I had it, it'd be under my bed. They say stuff I can't relate to. They be like, oh yeah, we've been watching HGTV. We decided to knock this wall out. I'm like, y'all knocking out walls? I could have used that wall. I was one wall away from being normal. Times got tough in New York. I had to get a moving job. I was a sorry mover. I would come with ideas that I thought were new. I was like, what if we make a bunch of little trips? They heard that one before. I always wanted to stay on the truck. Like, hey, y'all go in, move this stuff. I'm gonna watch the truck because we might need to move it. Somebody might need to pull the truck around. It was a sketchy business. I know it was sketchy because the first day I went to talk to the guy about working there, I brought two forms of ID because that's what you do when you start a job. And I gave the guy my driver's license. He just made fun of it and gave it back. He was just like, yeah, that's a goofy picture right there. I'm like, you're not going to photocopy that or nothing? I was robbed on the schedule. That's three letters. I'm like, if something happens to me, I'm not going to be able to track these people down. They used to always be like, Rob, you're so weak. I'm not weak. I just don't have a good grip. Like, you don't know your grip until it's tested. Like, my muscles are strong, but my grip is weak. My hands are moisturized. Boxes just slide right through. Like, I can lift anything. I can lift a dresser. I just got to put it down more frequently than other people. Just got to take more breaks. You rethink everything when you move a couch cushion and you got to use your face a little bit. Makes you rethink your life decisions. Like, yeah, this couch definitely got the seepage. I got sent home one day. That's embarrassing. They were like, we'd rather do this job with two people than three people. We just realized this is not a three-man job. This is my theory. Early in the day, I think they were like, this guy, he's young, he's gonna get better, he's gonna get stronger, we just gotta keep working with him. And then a Missy Elliott song came on the radio and I knew all the words. And they're like, that's just a weak grown man. You gotta go home, sir. You just perfectly feminine and when you didn't. Gotta get out of here. Not gonna cut it. They say in order for you to make it in comedy, you got to tell your story. But my story is boring as hell. Like, if I had a good story, y'all would have been heard about me. If I had a good story, man, I would have been on. I would have been on 60 Minutes. I wouldn't even been on some comedy stuff. People tell me about all the trauma they've been through in their life, I'd be so jealous. I'm like, man, if I had that trauma, I had 2 shows right now. I used to go to church, they'd be like, God doesn't give you more than you can handle. I used to be like, yo, God thinks I'm weak. You don't know, it's the grip. It ain't even. I know I got a boring story because I didn't get any scholarships I applied to. I used to be on fastweb.com applying to scholarships all the time. People started a rumor that if you go on FastWeb, you can get $100,000. I'd be telling my two-parent household middle-class stories. Nobody wants to hear that. Life is tough where I grew up. Everybody didn't make it home. I brought my Black Power Ranger to school. Somebody stole it. They don't want to hear that. If I had a good story, I wouldn't even be a comedian. I'd probably be a rapper. Rappers, they got the best stories. My track one would be amazing. Your track one, that's where you tell people all the stuff you've been through. My track one would be like, I grew up in the street. My mom tripped on the curb when she had me. I cut my umbilical on the concrete. I used to keep a razor blade in my car seat. I'd have bars like that. I remember my parents got divorced. My mom was like, use that in the essays. You're going to get so many scholarships. I was like, I come from a broken home. Life's tough now. Won't even have HBO anymore. I don't know what's going to happen on True Blood. Still didn't get any scholarships. I've always been different. The first tooth I lost, I ate it. That's the only one you got to bring home. People are excited about your first loose tooth. They're like, any day now, don't pick at it. Just wiggle it any day now. Let's see how loose it is. Ooh, it's super loose. I was at lunch, the tooth fell out my mouth. I thought it was a piece of bread. I put it back in my mouth before I realized it was not a piece of bread. I get home, everybody's like, where's the tooth? Where's the tooth? I was like, I thought it was a piece of bread. I ate it. My parents were so mad, they were like, man, we got food at the house. Out here eating teeth. That became my story. People come over, they be like, tell them what happened to your first tooth. I'd be like, I thought it was a piece of bread. I ate it. I always been different. I was a kid on a leash. Some of y'all looking perplexed, like a Black kid on a leash. I was the Jackie Robinson of leash kids. They don't talk about me Black History Month. Not enough days. I'm a day 31 guy at best. When I was a kid, I never saw myself as a child. I saw myself as an adult, like everybody else. If I saw something I liked, I would just walk towards it. I got separated from my parents. I would get someone to help me find my parents. Get someone to call them on the intercom. Parents hate that. So what my mom did is she got this thing, it had Velcro on it, and Mickey Mouse was locked down. It was not made by Disney. And it was connected to a thing that she would wear with Minnie Mouse on it. You can't give some parents certain things. Like, you're supposed to pull a leash. I would get yanked. My mom would use the leash like Scorpion uses his powers on Mortal Kombat. Like, get over here. They shamed my mom out of using the leash. They were like, you can't do that to your child. It's inhumane. It's not an animal. That's your child. So my mom stopped using the leash. But every time she gets an Amber Alert, I feel like she's like, see? Should have had him strapped down. Way easier to find that van if it's dragging a leash behind it. I'm so glad I'm a human being. I'm so glad humans don't have tusks. Like when humans fight, like we put them up. Like that's cool. Elephants, they gotta fight with their mouth. I don't wanna taste my enemies. You ever see two elephants going at it? They look like they kissing. They look like they making out until one of them don't make it out. I know about elephants because I watch Planet Earth. I watched so much Planet Earth, I ran out of Planet Earth. I started watching the making of Planet Earth. I'm like, really? Why y'all made this show? Y'all made a show about this show? I'm gonna watch that too. David Attenborough be on there making me sad. The planet is dying. The coral reefs are dying. I'm like, well, stop shooting them. Clearly y'all put the tripod on the coral reefs. Like, why y'all gotta show me that? Y'all ever think the animals on planet Earth, they know the cameras are there? I think some of them are like, I'm not even hungry, but I'm trying to get on Netflix. This for the species. This, we got to let people know how we roll, dog. We... I watch so much Planet Earth. I watch the other shows that are jealous of Planet Earth. I watch the show Night on Earth, and they not as good as Planet Earth because they always bragging about their cameras. Planet Earth don't ever brag about their cameras. They just show you something you never seen before. They just show you a glacier melting. They just show you a fox in Chernobyl. A raindrop on a leaf. You're like, yo, I ain't never been that close to a leaf. Night on Earth, they're like, every episode, we got the best night vision cameras on television. Like, stop talking about your cameras. I found out about my new favorite animal watching that. The grasshopper mouse. Grasshopper mouse undefeated. It got into it with a scorpion. I don't know what they was arguing about. But the scorpion did one of these. I was like, it's a wrap. Can't beat a scorpion. Scorpion started stinging the mouse in the neck. I was like, that's gonna blow up. This mouse gonna get sick. Grasshopper mouse just grabbed the scorpion and ate it. I was like, that's a thug right there. Pounded his chest and screamed into the night like, ah! That's hard. Humans, we forget we're animals. We think we better than the animal kingdom. We got laser hair removal, we think we removed. We still animals. Guys, we'll remind you we're animals. We can live in filth. We catcall. We send pictures of our penis. That's just us doing animal stuff. That's all a bird does when they chirp. They're just like, who trying to smash? Who trying to smash? Who trying to hit this? I got a puffy chest. Who wants this puffy chest on them? I got the puffiest chest on this power line. They call me the Puff Daddy over here. That's all they doing. Like, do y'all think roosters are our personal alarm clock? They don't care if we wake up. They just waking up horny in the morning like, what y'all trying to do? What y'all trying to do? What That's it. You ever think about the decisions you made in your life? If you change one thing, how it would affect your life? Like, I'm convinced I'd be in the NBA if I wasn't so into Pringles. That's the real difference between me and Steph Curry. We the same height. We both started playing at four. It's just he didn't have the Pringles summer that I had. I popped and then I didn't stop, you know? He probably ate carrots and celery. Is that depression? Is that depression? I should have known I wasn't going to be an athlete. I was a mouth breather. I was a kid nobody wanted to be in front of in the lunch line. I'd be behind you like... Will you close your mouth? I'm sorry. If I close my mouth, I'm going to die. Okay. Just trying not to die. I was a kid, everybody thought it was sleep first at a sleepover. Like, Robert, you sleep up there? No, I'm watching the same movie y'all are watching. That's my favorite part right here. I was a confident kid, though. Like, I would watch the draft. I'd be like, yo, I'm going to be up there one day. New kid come to school, I'd be like, hey, you want to race? I didn't even know I was slow. You beat me in a race, and I'd be like, man, you must be the fastest kid here. You just beat me. I only hang out with fast people. We should hang out. Let me introduce you to my fast friends. I found out I was slow at field day. I kept losing races. People was like, man, Rob, you out there playing around, aren't you? I was like, you know me, I'm always playing around. I was not playing around. I was out there trying my hardest. I was a sheltered kid. We couldn't watch rated R movies when I was a kid. We could only watch movies after they made it to cable. All my Spike Lee movies said Mickey Ficky a lot. My Die Hard 2 was like, yippee-ki-yay, Mr. Falcon. It's a little different. I couldn't listen to the dirty version of music. I could only listen to the clean version. The clean version is different from the radio edit. The radio edit, they take curse words out and put other fun words in. Like, wait till you see my all. Like, that's fun. The clean version, they just take all the curse words and play them backwards. So the S word becomes ish. And the N word becomes hugging. That changes the meaning of so many songs. Jigga My Hugging was so confusing when I was a kid. This one girl at our middle school, what she would do is she would sell song lyrics for a quarter and we'd buy them from her. And we'd listen to the clean version, but we'd read along with the dirty version. Like, oh, Jay-Z didn't hug anybody. He did stab someone in this song, though. My middle school, we had optional school uniforms. Optional school uniforms are when some kids wear the school uniform and then other kids make fun of those kids. Which defeats the purpose of a school uniform. The whole purpose of a school uniform is so that kids are not distracted by your clothes and then that way they can focus on your face. Like, kids are still terrible. They still gonna roast. They're like, all right, we're all wearing the same thing. Let's look at the back of your neck. I don't like how school made you conform. Like, I used to get in trouble for not standing in a straight line. I would be like, stand in a straight line. I used to want to boogie to lunch. That doesn't prepare you for adulthood. You can boogie now. Try it. Whenever I go to Chipotle, I be boogieing. They be happy. They be like, give them some extra meat then, all right? See how you walked in here, man? Give it to them. Even the games they have us play. Duck, duck, goose. Duck, duck, goose is basically you're normal, you're normal, you're normal, you're normal, you're weird. And then you just got to be athletic to get out of being weird. Who made up this game? Who wants to be a duck more than a goose? I've never gotten drunk off a great duck. I've gotten loose off of some great goose. We have a witness in here. They tell us all kind of stuff in school, and then they go back and, like, fix it. It'd be like, Christopher Columbus, and then after a while, it'd be like, remember Christopher Columbus? Yeah, that's not really what happened. Like, why'd you do that? Y'all remember the Thanksgiving play? Everybody count off ones and twos. One, two, one, two. If you're a one, you're Native American. If you're a two, you're a pilgrim. And then you had to color a little hat. Then you get to high school, they'll be like, oh yeah, remember the Thanksgiving play? Yeah, it didn't happen like that. Like, why'd you waste my time? My mom took off work for that play. They need to make a play that's gonna help you in your life. Like, everybody count off ones and twos. One, two, one, two. If you're one, you're state. If you're two, you're federal. This play's about taxes. That way you can go back and watch it and be like, all right, man, that was helpful. Thank you, five-year-old me. Tell us all kind of random stuff. Humans are 70% water. Why? We don't do any water stuff. You jump in the pool, you don't join the pool. I can stand on the drain all day. None of my friends evaporated. They told us George Washington had wooden teeth. Why do we need to know that? We don't know about anybody else in history's dental record. That's just some gossip from the 1700s. The worst part is George Washington's teeth weren't even made out of wood. They were made out of other human teeth. I'm breaking the news right now. George Washington's teeth were made out of other human teeth, not donated. Y'all do the math, y'all carry the one, y'all figure out slave teeth. They stopped selling wooden teeth merchandise at George Washington's Museum in Mount Vernon in 2020. 2020, they were like, the jig is up on these wooden teeth. Somebody done made a meme. Yeah, we can't sell any more magnets, no more chattering wooden teeth. I know, the gift shop's gonna be a little empty, but that's a weird prizes we got 2020. Like, we just want to be treated like human beings, and they're like, all right, but what about these pancakes? Like, let's get that situation together. Let's change Aunt Jemima to Pearl Milling. Like, that still sounds like an old black lady. That's the best y'all could do? Why don't you just call them PM pancakes? Like, what? They knocked down a lot of statues. That's cool. I feel like that's what you should do at the end. If I'm getting tased by the police and I see a platform that says Robert E. Lee with no statue, that's not gonna help. A lot of these statues are from the 70s. The Confederacy only lasted 5 years, 1861 to 1865. These statues are like 50-something years old. To put it in perspective, 21 Savage came out with It's an Album in 2017. He's got way more slaps than the Confederacy. He don't have a statue. Not in Atlanta, not in London, nowhere. Like, we keep having the same debates, and it's like, I thought by now we would be debating about different stuff. Like, there's still white people like, why can't I say the N-word? And I'm like, by now we should have other words white people can't say. This list should have got bigger. All we been through? Still going through? Like, I think white people shouldn't be able to say bougie. I feel like bourgeoisie, that's y'all word. Y'all got that. Y'all created that in Europe somewhere. We remixed it. Y'all shouldn't be able to just have the remix. If you say bougie at work, I should be able to write an email to HR like, hey, Trevor said bougie. Just want to let you know I was triggered. I don't think white people should be able to say musty. I never heard it happen. Like, I've never heard a white person say musty. So we should just, like, grab onto it. Draw the line somewhere. Take some easy ones. I don't think white people should say boo-boo the fool. I can't tell you the etymology of boo-boo the fool. I don't know who the first person who wasn't boo-boo the fool was. We got to draw the line somewhere, you know? We just want to be treated like people. And they're like, nah, all right. Y'all want brown Band-Aid? You got it. I didn't even know Band-Aids were supposed to be human color. I thought that was the color that they had. Rubber bands are that color, so I thought Band-Aids were that color. I do jokes about 2020. People be mad. They try to police comedy. They're like, you can't talk about 2020. People tired of it. It's over with. Just like, yo, this is the biggest thing I ever been a part of. Like, this is the only thing I got. Like, 9/11, I was in middle school. Nobody. People still making jokes about that. People still making jokes about Martin Luther King and World War II and stuff. But I gotta stop making jokes about 2020. All kind of stuff happened to me in 2020. I lost my best friend in 2020. Not to COVID, he just weeded me out. They're like, this is the time you gotta hold on to the people you love the most, and that's when I got let go of. We didn't even have a conversation. We didn't even have, like, guys, we don't do that. We don't just, you know, have a final closure conversation. I just got ghosted by the person I used to go to complain about being ghosted. I found out from a mutual friend that basically this friend felt like I had messed up priorities. But how do you get a friend with messed up priorities? Because you too have messed up priorities. You're not gonna evolve without me. We was buying them sections together. We was going in on them bottles together. And now I'm worried about the wrong thing. Now I be turning up in spite, getting a hookah. I don't even smoke hookah. I'm super friend of my other friends. I hit my other friends up all the time now. Be like, hey, you want me to pick up your kids? He'd be like, you sound weird. But sure, yeah, you can pick up the kids. I'd be like, hey, you need help moving? I'll call the truck. Like, that's about all I could do is just call the truck. But I'm not somebody with day ones. I got some day fives and some day tens, but I don't really got any day ones. Like, it's people I grew up with and I see on Facebook and run into when I'm home, but, like, I don't know what their house look like. People, like, told me when you go to college, you gonna meet the friends you have for the rest of your life. The people that told me that, when they went to college, there was no cable. There was no internet. They're like, when you get to college, you're going to meet some of your best friends. Y'all going to be playing cards all night. Like, that's all y'all had was cards. Y'all didn't have anything else. Y'all didn't have Madden. Talking about a different time. I could play Madden with somebody anywhere in the world. I thought I had a best friend when I got to college. It was a guy, and we clicked. We liked the same type of movies. We listened to the same type of music, hung together, watched the same TV shows. You was looking for him, probably come see me. You was looking for me, you probably go see him. Then the next year, he got a car and started a secret organization without me. People like, how do you know that he started a secret organization? I'm like, it's easy. They had matching t-shirts. That defeats the purpose of a secret organization when you got shirts that match your shoes. I was the most important person to this organization. You need people who want to be in a secret society who are not in it, or else it's just everybody's in it. It's not exclusive unless it's somebody who's not in it that wants to be in it. I used to ask them questions like, how do I get in? What can I do? They would say stuff back like, what can you bring to our organization? I only knew job interview answers. I'd be like, I'm good at PowerPoint, Microsoft Word. I'm nice on paint. I'm really nice on paint. I can fade from one color to the other color. I could use a spray paint. I'm a beast on there. The name of this organization was Zero Tolerance That Stops Here. And what it was a group of incels before incels. Just a group of guys that couldn't get laid, but they weren't an online community. They was an in-person community. And they wouldn't let me in. They wanted zero tolerance against hoes. They asked me questions like, hey, do you have any hoes? I'd be like, man, y'all know me. I'm trying. Y'all see what I'm doing out here. My whole friend group, I felt like, was in this group. They all had shirts. My whole social circle. I didn't trust anybody after that. I felt alienated. But also, I felt like I could go on stage and say whatever because I couldn't be embarrassed. I felt like nobody really was like that close to me, so then I started being funny. It was a defense mechanism. I already came to college insecure. When I got to high school, that's when people first started making fun of my teeth. I didn't know that could happen. Like, if somebody makes fun of your shirt, you can get another shirt. Somebody makes fun of your teeth, then it's like, I'm going to have these all of high school, hopefully. I used to watch shows like The Swan, Extreme Makeover. Extreme Makeover, they would give people lipo. They nose was over here, they move it back to the middle. And then they'd always be like, and porcelain veneers. Even if they needed it, their teeth could have been fine. They still in porcelain veneers. Like if plastic surgery was a cake, I felt like porcelain veneers was the sprinkles. I used to be at home like, I need those sprinkles. I used to say that all the time. When I get money, I'm going to get some veneers. When I get money, I'm going to get some veneers. My mom heard that, told my dad told my dentist. They got me 6 porcelain veneers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I hate this part of the show. This is when people start looking in my mouth. Making me feel uncomfortable. When you get porcelain veneers, what they do is they shave your teeth down to a little spike. And then they take a piece of porcelain and bond it to your tooth. So now your teeth are no longer a tool. It's just for show. I got this procedure in 2009. They last 10 to 20 years. I got to get on and popping soon. Or else I'm in a world of trouble. When you get porcelain veneers, like, they don't put you to sleep. They put your mouth to sleep. Your nose is awake. Your brain is wide awake. You get hit with debris in the face. You're like, man, that's my enamel. I need that. When I was getting it done, I don't know if they could legally show me what was going on. But they were like, hey, here, take this cup, rinse this. Whatever you do, don't look in the mirror. I took that as a challenge. I rinsed, I looked in the mirror. I was like, yep, my dreams are never going to be the same. I'm going to see that forever. After I got the procedure, they was like, you can no longer eat corn on the cob. I was like, that's fine. I don't even like corn on the cob. They were like, you can no longer bite into an apple. I was like, okay, I can cut up some apples. But now when I watch TV, I see somebody biting into an apple in a movie. I'm like, dang, I couldn't even have got that part. Yeah. They out here apple biting. That wasn't even in the size they said. Why not audition for that? He out here biting the apple straight out the fridge. That's crazy. They also said you can't bite into a chicken wing. Right. I'm from Atlanta, Georgia. If you would have said you got a choice between confidence and a 10-piece, I would have been like, yo, give me the 10-piece, man. Fry it hard, but throw it back in the grease. Give it to me. Lemon pepper. Come on, what are we doing? I didn't know my fighting days were over. Like, now if I get in a fight, I might lose a tooth and win the fight. People are like, what happened to you? Like, you should see the other guy, man. Just help me. I'm looking for a tooth around here somewhere. My biggest fear was like one of them sliding off like while I'm on the Breakfast Club or something. Like I'm talking to Charlamagne and then one of my teeth just fall off and then that became bigger than whatever I'm promoting. That was my biggest fear for a long time. I had too much confidence. That's too much to give a 20-year-old. Immediately, I became a jerk. After I got veneers, I was the type of person to look somebody dead in the teeth. I started attracting different women. Women who were into biting. I'm like, these are not even going to do what you think they're going to do. I can't really get down like you want me to get down. I hear what you're saying, but no, these are just for show. The minute I got veneers, about a couple weeks later, I started doing stand-up comedy. I was like, I'm a star now. I'm out of here. I'm going to make it. First time I got on stage, I pulled the mic out the mic stand, bust myself in the mouth. I feel like that was the game telling me it's gonna take a lot more than veneers to get on and popping in comedy. But I always felt like a fraud. I always felt like, would I have even gone on this journey without that super boosting confidence? Also, I felt like the people in my life thought I was ugly and wanted to fix it. For the longest, I felt like I was weak, but I wasn't weak. I just didn't have a good grip. When I had the moving job, I had bruises on my arms. It's crazy. My coworkers didn't have this at all. This is not their side effect. This is me. I told you my story is boring. The story of privilege. Look at that. Look at all these toys. This extremely boring story. Multiple big toys. This McDonald's, that fry machine was whack. That you just cut up bread. It's cut up bread, licensed cut up bread toy right there. This is me hooping. This is my coach. My first coach quit. He quit. He didn't even quit in person. He quit on a Colin Post message. Like, he was like, this is bad for my mental health. I'm not a loser. Y'all keep losing. Your new coach is Mr. Bell. I was like, Mr. Bell? He don't even go by coach. Like, I want a coach that wakes up in the morning and puts on sweatpants. I don't want somebody that loosens their tie when they get off work and now they coach. I don't want that. So this is the coach that stepped up right here. This is me putting lockdown defense on a girl. We played against a co-ed team at Ben Hill Gym, and yeah, this is me. That's a good stance, so you can't say the girl or not. That's solid. Clearly I was doing the drills, you know? Marcus Smart of my time. Obviously, I keep getting better and better. Okay, so in middle school, I didn't make the basketball team. We had tryouts 7th grade, 8th grade. I didn't make the team. I was crying. I asked the coach if I could be the mascot. The coach was like, yeah, you could be the mascot. Only thing, you gotta make the mascot costume. What do y'all think our team was? We were the Dolphins. This is me trying to make a dolphin. It's Mission Impossible. I only had middle school resources. You can get a tiger mask somewhere. They just don't have dolphin masks. These are real. This really happened. I blurred out faces to save the innocent and the not so innocent, but yeah, these dudes really had these shirts and whatnot. Also, they was taking pictures with girls and throwing up zeros. I don't think they consented to these pictures either. Funny story, these two are married now. Yeah, to each other. Yeah, so I think they did have tolerance. I think that did happen. These are how my teeth look before the procedure. That's me and my dad. That's when they was being prepped, so they scaled back some gums and whatnot. Y'all laughing, that's really what they do. On Facebook, this girl keeps posting this picture with my old teeth, and I feel like she's trying to humble me. Like every time I do something, she's like, oh yeah, Throwback Thursday, me and Rob Hayes, and it's like, all right, enough with it. I see what you're trying to do. And so that's how I looked before, and then that's how I looked immediately after. You can see I was playing, having a way better time. Tell by how red my eyes are in that second pic. And then, one of them fell off eating a pizza one day. And so, yeah, you just got walking around with it on there, but it's not really on there. That's until you get somebody to put it back on. Under you guys' seats, I have my own shirt. It says the opposite of what those shirts said. So if you look under your seats now, you got a shirt that says tolerance. It starts here. And you guys can be in my game. Yeah.
Production.